Hello everyone, and welcome to another one of my videos on remaking Puerto Pollo. First of all, I would really like to thank Alec Geo for pointing out a really interesting fact about the Curse of Monkey Island. In the leaflet, the instructions that came in with the CD, there was some art embedded in. So you could see a little part of the barbershop from behind, from a side. But this is concept art. So basically it was in a different position, different area, built in a different way, but still really gave me a lot of tiny, interesting details to add to my version of Puerto Pollo. So really, Alex Joe, thank you for that. If any of you find out any more interesting pictures or designs that were made by the original makers, please give me a shout. Second thing, as usual, please like and subscribe if you like my videos. I will be now continuing with the reconstruction of Puerto Pollo, and I'm moving on to the stairs on the side and the building on the side of the Barbary Coast building. I will be adding also some more little details. Getting on to the point of details, I've been working a lot on making the scene alive, as I always say. And what I decided to do is going again backwards in time with the second Monkey Island game. And I decided to add a bit of scruffiness to Puerto Pollo too. I will not remove that white candor that you see in Puerto Pollo. That kind of is typical of the area, and it would just ruin how it looks and feels like. But I will be adding little things like, I don't know, hanging clothes, gardening areas with different colored flowers, random trees that shouldn't really be in the area. Well, that was actually in Puerto Pollo. There are some trees that really shouldn't be even in the Caribbean. And also the buildings themselves, I mean the white plastered buildings. Normally in a pirate Caribbean cove you would find shacks made out of wood and pieces of ships or whatever debris they could find around. A little bit similar to favelas, basically. But what Puerto Pollo looks like is a very touristic modern town. So I'm gonna try and just scruff it up a little bit, but still keep that touristic feeling that makes it a calm and interesting area to explore. Furthermore, I will be also making them, first time actually, I'll be making some flowers, cartoonish style. I mean, hyper-realistic flowers are actually easier for me to make, but cartoonish style ones are difficult and interesting. I can just play around with them and make this wonderful, inexisting species and add them to the flora. And I will be adding some more marine theme objects around, like nets and barrels. So without further ado, I'll let you watch the video. So please subscribe, like the video, or don't like it, leave comments about things that you might find interesting, or you would like to change, or anything that you don't.